Welcome to our Christmas Heritage Concert. We're going to open up with the Mass piece, and I just wanted to read what the lyrics are. It's a Nigerian Christmas carol, and this is what you're going to be hearing. We rejoice, for we have a trustworthy Father. We rejoice, for we have a dependable Father. Where was Jesus born? Where was he born? Bethlehem. The city of wonder. That is where the Father was born, for sure. Praise, praise, praise be to you. We thank thee for this day, gracious Father. Praise be to the merciful Father, the Father who created us. I can think of no better way to open our concert than to be singing praise to a king. Oh, I always cry. I told them I was going to cry. To a king who came as a vulnerable little baby only to save us from our own sin.
Amen.
So here we go. This is called Bethlehem.
Bethlehem, Bethlehem,
grade. And we have a really special addition to our staff. She's gonna hate me for doing this, but her name's Kimberly Rubish. Go ahead and stand up, Kimberly. And she is teaching kindergarten through fifth grade choir, and it is an amazing feat to get kindergartners to sing Nigerian folk music. So, Kimberly, thank you. And as we kind of transition here, the kindergarten through third grade choir is gonna go up on stage, and I'm gonna turn it over to Mrs. Turner.
All right, well, welcome. Thank you so much for being here. My name is Jane Turner, and I'm the director of this program, and I feel more and more every year like the burden is just getting spread around to all these amazing people, and I kind of just show up to this night, and it's wonderful. Actually, Mrs. Caro and I, one of our art teachers, were just reminiscing. This is our 7th concert and art show, and today, for the first time, we set up the entire art show starting at 9 in the morning, and we're completely finished by 1. 7 years ago, we started like the entire day before the art show, and when all of our volunteers left, we had no idea what we're doing. Trina and I took down all of the art and reset it up the way that we wanted it to be. So it's really amazing to be at this place with so many wonderful people here. To the parents, thank you for sharing your children with us. They are really just a blessing. It's a blessing for us teachers to be able to partner with you and to have our students here learning in community. So I just would like to acknowledge the teachers here at Heritage. If they would all just stand up, you can just see who they are and give them a round of applause. They work so hard, and I'm just honored to stand beside them and to see all of the creativity that they bring here. I just really quick wanted to share with you, we've been working through the Apostles' Creed in assembly. I know that's a new thing for some of the families here, and just wanted to share a little bit about that choice. This is something that the Apostles' Creed that has been said throughout the world for 1600 years by the people of God. That's really amazing. I think we live in a country of America. I've just been reading a book, and it talks about how America, we like to do things new. We want to be new and novel, and let's change up the way that we worship, and let's change up the things that we do, just as standard practice. But this Apostles' Creed is something all over the world, every single week, that is said in many different languages. So even as we come here tonight and hear these kids singing praises to Jesus in a different language, this Apostles' Creed unites us as the people of God. And so we actually tonight are going to stand together as believers and proclaim what we believe. We've been talking with the kids all year about the power of stories that especially just really show the same pattern as the gospel story, that of creation and the fall and redemption and restoration from a God who came to save his people. So if you would just stand with us, I wanted to explain one line, especially to those of you who might be new to this. It does say in there, one holy Catholic church, and that is Catholic with a little c, which means the universal church. The church, you all come from different churches in this valley, but we all belong to one church, the church of God. So our students have memorized this, they're gonna say it with us. People of God, what is it that you believe? I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He ascended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, sits on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall
didn't. Just a couple of announcements before I pray. Before I pray for us. One, we have our student council decided that they wanted to run a fundraiser for the Sparrow's Nest, which is an organization here in the community that serves the local homeless population from our high school students. So there are 350 homeless students in the Flathead Valley who go to our local high schools. So and obviously that is a huge number. The Sparrow's Nest right now is housing six of them in Kalispell, and I don't know how many in Whitefish, but our students are selling cards and ornaments that they made this year. So if you want to participate in that or just give a donation to Sparrow's Nest, all of the proceeds go towards that. And then just a huge thank you to our choir teachers and our art teachers. Be sure to thank them for all that went into this night here. And I think that we're ready to get started. So let me pray for us, and then we get to hear. Have you guys sat so still? Thank you. All right, that's fine. God, you are the dependable Father. You are the merciful Father, the gracious God, Lord. Thank you for saving us. Thank you for this Christmas season, Lord. Even when we have hard things in our life, it's not always easy to celebrate this time of year, but you are good, and we know that. So I just pray for each of these students. I pray that they would use their voices to glorify you. Thank you that we can participate in this worship. And I pray for each one here tonight, Lord, that you would just reveal yourself as the loving and powerful and gracious God tonight in this place. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, good evening. This is the kindergarten through third grade choir. They meet separately, so second and third grade, I see them at 9 o'clock in the morning, and the kindergarten and first grade, I don't see until 3 o'clock. And some of them are here all day. And so choir at the end of the day, sometimes difficult, but they've done so well, and I've been so proud of all the work that they've done, and I know that we're all excited to share this music, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
4th and 5th grade choir, and they've also put in a lot of work. One of the things we do, which you probably know because you've heard them at home, but our practice CDs, and I held a competition between kindergarten and 5th grade, how many times they listened to their CD, and then this choir, let's see, Vanessa, how many times? 138. That's a lot of times to listen to the CD. So it's really great. So I'm also very proud of the work that they've put into learning their music. Enjoy again.
Okay, so coming to the stage, we have the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade choir. This is such a fun and energetic group. I just love working with them, and there's nothing quite like young voices that we just heard, and a little bit older, but still young, considering how old I am and some of us are in the room, to hear them just singing praises to the Lord. It's just such a treat. Not only, I mean, you get to hear them tonight, polished and ready to perform, but I get to hear them every single week and see the progression and just see that their hard work pay off, which is a really special privilege. So we have 6th, 7th, and 8th grade choir, and their first song is called Walk to Bethlehem, and it's a modern twist on a traditional carol. And I also need to apologize. Max Gwynn, raise your hand. He was our percussionist on the Mass piece, and I totally forgot to give him the credit he deserved. He did an amazing job. I didn't help him. That amazing note. pieces on the fly, making up her own endings because I didn't like the way that it was. I ask a lot of her, and she always comes through with a smile, which is just a testament to her character. So when you have an accompanist like this, you take advantage of it, and you take a simple song that has a really difficult accompaniment piece because you want to show her off. So this is our choir song, but we're all kind of featuring Miss Stallworth. She hates it when I do this, but she so deserves it, and I want to make it known. So here we go. God rest you, merry gentlemen.
Thank you.
Kufu. And we have Andrew Turner playing the tambourine, which really adds a lot to our piece. Whoever said the tambourine was a boring instrument never heard this song, clearly.
Bum 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 b Have you seen
the newborn king?
Have you seen